noise. I hope you guys had a great week. Tonight we're going to be watching some really cool gal pals rage and destroy each other. I'm kidding. No. tonight we're going to watch some amazing Overwatch. I think this format is a little bit mixed and matchy with Stevens College and Notre Dame. Is it the high school?
Yeah, it's the high school.
Yeah. And as you can see, I have a new co-caster with me, so you don't have to listen to me cast. you might have remembered, well, I don't know, they just put knock, so you're like incognito right now, but you have played in some of these Overwatch scrims, casuals, I don't know what to call it, but you have played on here before, so mm-hmm. Do you want to introduce yourself? Go ahead.
Yeah, sure. Hi. I'm Nocturnal, but everyone just calls me Noc because that's way easier. I played in these like the first time we did them, and they were super fun. But now I'm here casting, so it's great.
Yeah, and tell them who you usually play or what. Tank.
What role?
Yeah. Role. There we go.
I'm an off tank player, so I play like D.Va. I'm like a hard D.Va one trick. It's really bad. I actually have a D.Va chair, so you know. Ooh. And then I play Zarya, Roadhog, and Sigma. Those are like my best. But
I'm learning Sigma. I call him Toes. He's pretty cool. I like him a lot.
Yeah, he's fun.
So are you excited? We're going to talk about you a lot because you're very interesting.
Okay.
How long have you been playing Overwatch?
I've been playing since it ever came out. I wasn't part of the beta, but like as soon as it came out live, I was playing it. I like pre-purchased it and it's been history ever since. It's like my most played game and I love it so much.
Am I low again? I'm so sorry.
I think so, maybe a little bit.
No, it's my microphone. Now I'm extra loud and I'm sorry. But yeah.
It's okay.
So you know Alithia, who's Steven's coach, and you kind of help out there, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you know, you have the tea. You have the inside information.
Yes, I do.
I was going to say, how do they work over there? Because I'm just going to say from the outside looking in, it looks like a well-oiled machine. Everybody is like, you know, you guys play very aggressive. It's like, I don't know. I always say it's like they know each other. Like, you know, you guys pick up sometimes if you slack off a little bit, you guys pick it up right away. I shouldn't say you guys, but they do that. So tell us what you know.
I mean, all the players over there are great. They work amazingly together, and Illy is really just kind of like the brains behind the operation. I mean, she's an incredible coach, so she kind of just tells them what to do, and sometimes they'll just, you know, practice it in scrims or whatever, or they'll look at VODs and, you know, stuff like that, and they'll figure it out and they play it well, and it's amazing.
What else? I believe were you in this scrim, the first one you said, right?
Yeah, I was.
Oh, okay. What was that like mixing and matching?
It was a bunch of fun. I mean, all the girls that play from Notre Dame and Stephens, they're just so cool, dude. I don't know, like I've done pickup games before, but I'd say that, you know, I've definitely had the most fun playing in these, for sure.
Yeah. We were supposed to talk about fitness and gaming. So I'm gonna just ask your personal opinion about fitness and gaming. Like, do you have a routine, even if it's like mental or just like getting up and doing stuff? Because I, you know, do you just sit at your computer unhealthily 24 hours a day? No, I'm kidding.
You know, I should be better, right? Mm-hmm. But mm-hmm. I do try to go for a run like once a week, just to, you know, get moving, especially since, you know, kind of a pandemic, not a lot to do.
True.
So,
but even before that, because, you know, you've been playing for a while.
True. Yeah. No, I always try to do like something active once a week, but I should do more.
Yeah. You think you should do more? I mean, I think if you do something once a week, cardio is really good, you know. What about like just like mentally prepare? I know we did an interview with a bunch of like wellness and stuff, and they have like diffusers and scents and things like that. Do you have anything like that?
I don't. I mean, I have a humidifier, but
hey, those are very important. Okay.
True.
They are. Yeah. It tells them because people don't realize, especially if you have PC, it kind of like sucks the air out of the room because it's like,
oh yeah.
Yeah. So it's actually really good to have a humidifier. So yeah. That's cool. And where do you currently go to school? And can you talk about the program that you're involved in?
Yeah. I go to UNCC. So University of North Carolina, Charlotte. And I'm a freshman, so I just joined this year and new to the program. We have a bunch of different teams, but I'm on the Overwatch team, and I don't know, it's been a lot of fun. And we're in the TESPA circuit right now, and we have a match on Sunday because we made it past the qualifiers, so yeah, that's cool.
Hey, you can gloat a little bit. What are you trying to, like, humble it down? Like, no, we did that. We're in Tesla. We're in quarterfinal. That's good. That's good. Yeah. I saw you, like, humble it there. We talked about that, okay? It's okay to be successful, women, okay?
You're right.
Good. Are you nervous? I could tell you're a little bit antsy. But
yeah, a little bit.
All right. What are you looking for tonight?
Tonight, like in the players?
Yeah. Like, what are you excited about, like, watching as a... Because I know you play, so you're going to be an observer, and of course you're going to be casting with me. So is there anything specific you're looking for? Are you always looking at, like, your tanks or, you know, getting sufficient heals, stuff like that?
Yeah, I'd say I'm definitely looking at the tanks. I want to see some team kills, for sure. Ooh. For sure. If there's some D.Va bombs, I want all six gone. But we'll see. But...
high expectations.
Yeah. I know they can do it. Like, you know.
Hey, no pressure. All right. So, okay. So we want to welcome everybody in the chat and let you guys know there is another Corsair giveaway. We've been doing these for a couple weeks now. So make sure you put in your ticket. You could enter up to 1,000. To do it is !tickets, space, and then 1,000, I guess. But if you don't have 1,000 tickets, you know, just keep watching and you'll be able to acquire all the tickets. But tonight's giveaway is a Corsair keyboard that's really pretty. I almost rigged this contest so I could win it. I was telling everybody here, not could say, right? I said I was going to rig it so I could get this pretty keyboard.
It's really sick. It's awesome.
Yeah, so if it says you failed, try a lower number, like 100. And keep going until it tells you, like, you can't enter anymore. But, yeah, make sure you enter. We're going to keep reminding you in between games as well. And, yeah, I'm not sure. Are we ready? Are we ready? We might not be. Okay. You know, I'm very terrible. Oh, yep. Okay, very good. I was going to say, I'm very terrible at observing. Ooh, Ilyus. Okay. Do you have a favorite, like, unless it's like a character that you play, like a non-character you play, do you have somebody like you like to watch or see them?
Are you talking about character-wise?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I love a good Soldier 76.
Really?
Yeah. For sure.
You're surprising me. I didn't expect these answers.
I mean, I've been known to lock the legs a little bit. Mm-hmm. A little bit. But, I mean, he's just fun to watch. Because he runs around. He just looks like a dork. But other than that.
Yeah.
Thanks for my favorite.
Yeah, so they're basically picking their characters now. I think we see a Symmetra. A Genji. I don't think we've had Genji play.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
But hey, I don't mind it. I actually don't mind it.
Mm-hmm. And they're on a sim too, so that's gonna be interesting to see. Oh, off the map.
Yeah. Is there anyone who you played with, like, that's been playing tonight that you, like, remember just, like, doing, like, a cool, like, you know, call-outs together or anything like that? I'm sorry for all these weird questions.
Okay. I know Laplios. She played super well last time. Mm-hmm. She's really good. Who else?
Yeah, Laplios, actually, so there was another game where it was school versus school, and it was just really fun to watch how, because Laplios was just, like, it was kind of dominating. I think they won every game. And it was just really wild. I think it was the first time I actually spectated from in-game, and I was, like, watching from Laplios' perspective, and I was just so, like, I was getting excited. I thought you would have thought I was at the Overwatch League. I was so excited. I was like, oh my god, do you see this? It was just ridiculously just fun to watch, you know?
Yeah, she's nuts. Alright, looks like they're rolling out here. Red team's kind of on, like, a rush situation.
Yeah, and right away we're getting into some action. We've got two divas.
Oh no, okay, Lef gets a pick on the Reaper. Let's go.
So we're getting really into the thick of things. I literally looked down at Mekitsen and I looked up and everyone was fighting.
Oh my god.
But wow, nice pick here, and I'm watching from Silver Dipper, and wow, what a diva.
I know.
Are you a proud diva main right now?
Oh yeah, I am, and she's got 81 ult charge already. That's crazy. It's huge. And I really thought that Ro was going to take that point because they were there first, but I mean, Lap got a pick, and the rest of the blue team rushed in, and they were able to take it.
What do you think about the character choices for each team so far?
I would say Blue's team, their picks are a little more unconventional. Mm-hmm. This seems to be working out. And Silver Dipper gets a pick on D.Va. What a queen.
I just love the energy of these games because it's just like, it's just so competitive, like straight out the gate. I should have been used. I should have just not looked at my pizza at this point because I was like, usually when we start these games, they're right there, and then it just gets popping really quick. So,
We go. Let's see here. Oh, Big Co coming out from Battlehawk, pushing in. Oh, Counter Co. Oh my.
Oh.
Laplios trying to find. Oh, and. Unfortunately, she gets picked by Superwolf.
Yeah. I was going to say, are they playing actual teams? Because it does say Notre Dame, but I'm not really sure.
No, I think I'm... Oh, wait, they... No, it really is. It's Steffens versus...
Notre Dame, right?
Yeah, okay. They're not mixed at all.
Yeah, this is definitely not mixed. All right. See, now we can even talk even more in depth because we've seen Stephens College like play before, and we've seen them with this kind of very edgy comp. And here we go. And here. Oh, what is that? Three alts going off at the same time.
Yeah. Oh, my, another big bomb coming out. Won't find anyone.
Oh, found two and a turret and.
Yeah, I think Stefan's Kyle's will just clean this up. It's just the supports left on the point.
Oh, wow.
Get that Lucio.
Yeah, that's what a little bit of my confusion in the beginning there, because I'm like, are they all actually on teams? But yeah, they are. So this is very interesting. And game one. Wait, nope. It's not game one. That was just the first point. Oh, my goodness. It was just so much excitement.
Okay. I know. Yeah, I was expecting them to, like, do the pugs, but I mean... Hey, this works too.
Yeah, this is good. And I think this builds off like team, you know, they already know each other and it's always interesting. And I like actually when it's like school because I feel like you learn better, you know, like as you learn from each other, and those are your teammates for not forever, but for a while.
Oh yeah, for sure. There's definitely more like built up synergy between everyone.
But what a fun packed first round, and let's get into the second round. I actually love Ilio so much. It's one of my favorite maps.
I don't know.
Yeah, it's just really fun. I'm a Lucio main, listen.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. There's a lot of places to boop some people off here I'm not too fond of, but...
Yeah, Lucio and Sim and even some Torb on here is just really fun.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Stefan's here has the point already.
Yeah. They're
super aggro. Look at him go. Already getting the D.Va mech, too.
Yeah. And I really like watching Stevens College because they really, they know, I feel like they know where each character is as far as like tanks. We've seen them focus tanks before and it looks like they've done it again. It's usually like tanks go first or healers go first. And it kind of works out in their favor.
Oh yeah, for sure. I think Stefan's is they're really good at their positioning and playing behind their tanks. And I mean, they're Ana, for example, she's, you know, she's in a spot where the Notre Dame's going to have to commit so her team can peel just in case.
Oh, man. And look at this stopping.
Oh my. Ally Rogue going to the point. Oh, my. Little questionable play. Oh, B comes out. Will they be able to do anything?
So if you're Notre Dame right now, how would you react to this kind of choke situation?
Yeah, I mean, they should definitely back up and reset. Especially because they keep trying to fight as like, you know, five players against six, and then at that point it's just not winnable. You gotta back up. But I mean, they're in a good spot. They've got a couple ults going to this next fight. They have Pulse, Trank, they have D.Va Bomb, and they're close to Blade too, so maybe they can do something.
Wow. I don't know why you're nervous. You're really good at this caster thing. I'm just here eating pizza. No, but we wanna welcome everybody in the chat. I hope you guys are enjoying this. This is just a really casual match. I'm sorry. This is over.
Oh yeah. It's a...
Oh no. I mean, that's okay. We got a D.Va bomb pending here from Silver Dipper. And just wow. We don't even get it.
Nope.
Oh, you think they like seeing that, you know, Stefan's win thing in the
maybe a little bit. Maybe a little bit.
All right, here we go.
Oh, this destination. Is huge.
All right, here we go. Is this it's from the first point. Die, die. Oh wow.
Oh my.
Okay, and that was a nice cleanup right there. And that's a really good player of the game. So that was the first match. Oh my god.
Oh yeah,
I forgot it was coming back to the screen. Thank God you didn't see my pizza. Shout out to production. I know he's probably seen me stuff my face halfway through this. No, but what did you think about the first round? It was really awesome. And it's really good to see like the good manners in chat, all the GGs come out. But what a great match.
Oh, yeah. I'd say Stefan's definitely came to just to win this match. Like, oh, my goodness. I know Silver Dipper, she's like a support player, but... Mm-hmm. I mean, she was playing D.Va. That's cool. Like, she was doing great.
Yeah, and it was really fun to watch. I mean, just straight out the gate again. I mean, I've watched them play three times now, and it's really fun. It's, like, really great as casters even to watch it because you're kind of chill at the first part, and you're like, oh, yeah, they're picking their players. And then it's, like, 3-2-1, and then it's, like, boom, right away, and you're like... Oh, okay. This is what we're doing. It's always fun to just watch it. They're so competitive and it's just great to watch. How did you think Notre Dame played and what do you think they could do better to get like the next match?
I think they played well. I just think they got just unlucky. I mean, Destination was just an absolute menace on Reaper, you know? Like, death from above, my goodness. Because I don't think Notre Dame has a problem building ults, but maybe just, you know, using them and maybe using them together would really help them.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to say, it's really great to see how, like, Stevens really just, they play together. And like I said, sometimes they really focus tanks or DPS. I could tell because it's like everybody just focuses on that one person until they die. And that's like really crazy. So it's just really fun to watch. Also, I want to remind chat that we do have a giveaway. Make sure you enter. It's a Corsair keyboard. It's really cute. If you don't want it, that's okay. We'll keep it, you know, they'll send it to me. Let me know, but make sure you do exclamation ticket space and the number of tickets. You could put up to 1,000. And we're also gonna have an interview sometime during this. And it's gonna be about fitness and gaming. And we just have a lot of stuff. You guys are like, why is Allie relaxed? Why is she so like zoned out? They literally were like, next week you don't have to do it. It's Thanksgiving week. And I my mind was like, oh, it's next week.
Yeah, right.
Like I'm in vacation mode. No, but yeah, we won't be here next week. So make sure you enjoy the stream. Tweet it out. Make sure you hit the follow button. And yeah, show some love to Nox. She's been amazing so far. She was nervous. Why were you nervous?
I don't know. It's just, I've never done Overwatch this before. I know.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Listen, they made me like, I shouldn't say they made me, but they asked me to cast for League of Legends. Yeah, I can't name 5 characters.
Oh my God, no way. Dude, I don't know I don't know anything about League.
I just had to study for a week. I basically studied for a whole week. And thank God they had a patch so I could read patch notes and all that stuff. Sometimes you just got to get in the zone. I'm not going to say that. Shout out to our sponsors as well. NFL Alumni, ESTV, and Corsair.
Make sure you guys get those tickets, okay? The keyboard's sick.
Yes.
Tell your friends.
And we see all the support in chat. Thank you guys. You guys are so amazing tonight. Really, really do appreciate it. So are we getting ready for our next match? Usually I cheat and try to look at what map they're about to do, and it's Hanamura.
Oh.
Yeah. That's another question I could ask you. Do you prefer payloads or points? Like, what's your favorite kind of maps on Overwatch?
My favorite, I like escort a lot, or like payload maps.
Yeah,
just because it's like you're always getting progress in, and it's not like 2CP where you can be fighting on the point for like 4 minutes and then you don't get it, you know?
Yeah, I like it unless it's Gibraltar.
Oh yeah,
it's, I don't know, it's something about that map, it just makes it like extra long and I'm just like 4 more minutes.
Yeah, oh yeah. And especially with Gibraltar, it's really easy to get stuck in like a spot.
Yeah, and like you gotta get the payload like off the corners, and then once you get further down you gotta get it. It's just so much. But yeah, do you have a specifically like favorite map?
I mean, my favorite map would probably be King's Row. Even though it's not a build map, it's a hybrid. It's just, it's the OG. It's the best map in the game.
It's very, I'm going to say classic.
Oh, yeah.
That's so good. Yeah. Classic. All right, we're getting back into a game. But yeah, hope you guys are enjoying this. Let us know who you're rooting for in the chat. It's always fun to... Well, I kind of like, oh, so last time I believe we had escort matches for like the first couple of maps. So this time it's really nice to see like point play where like you have to capture and all that stuff, because I feel like you could recover a little bit better than for like escort.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know why.
For sure. But
yeah. So that's why we see them like, you know, being like super like out the gate, trying to make their way in and or even holding the point. It's always just fun to watch that back and forth as well. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I guess I'm the opposite of you because I do like, but I'm not sure because there so are some escort maps I like.
Yeah. So what's your favorite map?
Ilios. I'll say Ilios. That's right. Oh, yeah. That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. Control points.
For a newer map, Busan is actually a close second. I really like that map. I troll so heavily. Oh, it's so good. I'm a troll. I'm sorry.
It's good. No, it's good. It's good.
They're going to try to 1v1 me again tonight. I'm just going to leave spectate. The last time Stevens College was... in a thing, I think I had to, I'm not sure who I had to 1v1, but I lost. But I got one, you know, death.
Was it Illy? Or Alithia? I'm pretty sure. Yeah.
No, I didn't do Alithia. That was Black Crystal did Alithia. I think I had Laplos.
Oh, yeah. Okay, it looks like both teams are just kind of fighting at the choke here.
Yeah, it's very interesting, this part. And quick play, this is the worst map because...
Oh, yeah, for sure.
If you don't have a very, like, aggressive tank or somebody to dive, you know, like that dive comp or something to kind of sneak in there, this right here is annoying.
Oh, yeah, this is the worst. Like, they're... Notre Dame, really, their tanks just have to just... really just get in there just a little bit.
Oh, like, be little... aggressive. Be I'm sorry, I challenge.
Oh no, the hook from Ormer finding out of Rogue.
And you really hate to see it because Orisa is the worst to walk back. When you play her, you kind of want to avoid dying as much as possible. And yeah. It kind of sets them back because, again, this is team play, right? You're going to need every man on deck, so.
Yeah.
It's really good that they all went back after.
Oh, yeah. And they're actually in a really, really good spot this fight because they have Grav. They have a lot of ults to back up their Grav, and necessarily Stefan's College doesn't have, like, a good ult to counter Grav, so. Ooh, big pick by Super Wolf, too.
Oh, yeah. And usually, but I mean, the back and forth is always kind of here until the alts build up, right? And then we're going to see a big push coming in.
That's big. That's big. Oh my goodness! No. Super cool with the 3k on Junkrat into the Grav.
Hate to see it. You just really hate to see it. But that is what you have to do. You have to... You know what the other team is trying to like build up to kind of do their big push, and you have to hold on to your alt because it could save your team from getting picked up here. But it looks like they're contesting the point, and
yeah, they're gonna have to really focus on their targets here to clean this up. Oh no! Oh no, they're so close! Oh no.
Nice res there from Mercy.
Oh yeah, that was a huge res.
Oh man, and Ally Rogue goes down again, and it's really, really a tough situation. You really kind of have to kind of go back to square one when it's like this, right? You kind of have to build back up or figure out a way to kind of go back around. I know they're kind of contesting the door right away. There is a way around in Hanamura.
Yeah, I mean, most teams, they'll pull out a sim here, and I bet you Stevens College will do it on attack, but it's just so good to get past this door, because this door is the absolute worst. Oh my. Yep, Stefan's just being aggressive with the sim wall. That's really good. Silver Dipper actually fragging.
Yeah, and I really love how Notre Dame is kind of reacting to all the stops as well, because they got a little bit of the point there.
Yeah.
But it's just...
They were so close. They almost had it. I mean, they really got him. They really got Stefan's at the door. I mean, that was a big tire, huge grav. It was just unlucky spawns, and then Stefan's got the res on point. It was over.
Yeah, but I mean, that was just round one. You gotta prepare for round two, and, you know... It's kind of unfortunate, but now you want to do what the other team just did to you.
Oh, yeah.
And you want to stop them because it's just like, you know, they get a little bit of that point and it's over. So, but I'm really liking their reaction. They actually are having, but Stephens just, is it Stevens or Stephen? It's Stevens, right?
Oh, it's Stevens. It's me. I see the it's spelt weird and then my brain just, it's my fault.
You know what? I heard you and then I said it and then I'm like, wait, it's Stevens.
Yeah, it's my bad.
No, it's okay. But they have such great reactions. So even if you react to their reaction, they will react to it. I don't know if you guys follow that. But this is why I asked you about Alithia, because it just seems like they're just such a well-oiled machine when they come into these games. They look super prepared. And I know she like has like game plans and, you know, things like that as well. So it's just really fun to watch because, again, it's Notre Dame is a high school. So it's just like, even if it's a loss, it's still like a learning experience to kind of be like, oh yeah, we can, you know, kind of capitalize on this or that.
For sure, for sure.
All right.
And I mean, Notre Dame's comp, this is gonna be hard for Stephen. Oh, and the TP!
Oh no!
I knew it. I knew they'd do it. Yeah. Notre Dame. Oh, the Bastion Stinger. That's good.
Oh. Defend. Oh, no. Now I'm a cheerleader. Oh, and down goes Ally Rogue and GG. Yeah, I was just going to say, and they pull out a Symmetra, and as soon as it was going to come out my mouth, they teleported inside.
Yeah, I knew they'd do that. It's just such a good way to get past the door on Hanamura.
You know what? Every time I have they ask me if I want like a school versus school thing, I'm just gonna request Stevens College for Overwatch because and then bringing a co-caster so they could all be like, oh my god.
Right?
It literally happened every time where somebody's just like, oh my god, it's over. And
oh yeah, that was a really quick cast.
Yeah, so we get a break, yay. I'm not really sure. So right now we're gonna go into a quick interview before we talk about what we just saw there. And it is Caitlin McGee. She is a physical therapist with a background in neuroscience and exercise/sports science. She is the co-owner and performance esports medicine director of 1HP, a company that provides health and performance services to players, teams, and organizations. She additionally works with high school and collegiate esports programs to develop health and wellness standards. I'm trying to go through a chat. You also design programs to optimize player and team performance and to provide player education. Hey, that's why you're here. She's an editor and contributing author to two upcoming esports medicine textbooks and has been working in esports medicine for 6 years. Welcome. Hi. It's amazing. No, literally, because I always ask them for the interviewees' bios and stuff just so I can learn a little bit, just so I can kind of roll some questions at you. But yeah, I mean, can you like tell us first of all about 1HP and what you're doing there? Yeah, I mean, a lot of people, of course, when they hear esports, you're like, oh, what does that have to do with like real sports? Or you're not, you know, doing anything physical or, you know, stuff. We hear the, I mean, those are just some of the stereotypes you're talking about. as far as like fitness and, cause we've been, I feel like we've been talking about this for like 3 weeks because it's just, especially with COVID and everybody being inside, I feel like everybody's gaming. I mean, the new gens just came out as well. So, as far as fitness, what do you guys like recommend, and like what do you do with fitness and esports as well? I know that's a two-parter, but yeah. Mm-hmm.
Great, go running. If you don't like running at all because you're a normal human being, totally fine. Go find something else you love instead. Maybe it's rock climbing or martial arts or weightlifting. Maybe it's cycling or swimming. Whatever it is that you'll actually keep doing. Now, obviously, right now, things are a little bit different, right? I hope you're not going to a gym regularly. And I hope you're not regularly up close and personal with other people. And so finding things that you can do throughout your day is also really helpful. Setting yourself timers or alarms, especially when you're playing, or using kind of in-game landmarks, like say you've died, it's going to take you 20 seconds to respawn. You pop up, you do like 5 squats and you sit back down. That's still better than nothing. That will also increase your blood flow, which does help both physically in terms of blood getting to your muscles and cognitively in terms of blood getting to your brain, helps you play a little bit better.
But I hate squats. No, I'm kidding.
It can be whatever you want it to be. It can be calf raises, squats, lunges, push-ups, sit-ups, planks, side shuffles, running in place, jumping jacks, burpees. I can keep going for a while. I've got a very long list of things you could potentially do. So look, as a general rule, like if you're taking a break, right, there's two things you want to do. You want to move what you haven't been moving, and you want to rest what you have been moving. So you want to move your legs and your torso because you've been sitting still, more likely than not. And you want to rest your hands and your arms. So maybe you stretch them. Maybe you just let them hang out. Maybe you take a couple deep breaths. Maybe you do some quick posture exercises. But you're letting things that have been stiff move. You're letting things that have been moving.
As you say things,
rest.
I'm like moving. I'm like, am I sitting straight?
That is the usual side effect of... I come on an episode with somebody and I say the word posture and everybody immediately sits up a little bit straighter. I don't do it on purpose, I swear. It's just a magical power.
I mean, posture is such a huge thing. I actually, I'm a streamer, so I have like a posture check in my channel points.
Awesome.
So people could click it. And I also have like hydrate and things like that.
And that's like, one of the really great things you can do when you're streaming too, right? That you're making it an interactive thing and you're reminding your chat at the same time.
Yeah. And I mean, they need to do it too, because they're probably just sitting there watching me. But yeah, it's just really cool. What else? Oh, I wanted to ask you about like what you do with 1HP as far as with teams. Do you go in and just recommend like what they do, or how would you tell like a team or organization to do like their fitness and health?
Because I have to give a really physical therapy answer of it depends, which if you've ever talked to a physical therapist before, we say that a lot because it's usually true. It depends on where the players are at mostly and kind of what the organization is looking for. We won't, you know, go in there and put in like a comprehensive lifting program if the players have never had to do anything fitness wise. So a lot of what we do with teams is we listen, we figure out where they're at and kind of meet them where they are. So maybe we set a measurable goal of the whole team is going to take 1 10-minute walk per day. And you know, everybody's going to have, 3 servings of fish in a week. And you're going to create your own bedtime routine, whatever works best for you. You're going to figure it out. It's going to be about 10 minutes long and you're going to do it consistently. Once we're doing those things,
what does fish do?
Fish is just, it's good and healthy for you. It's, you know, it's brain food. It's got those omega-3s and omega-6s. You don't have to eat fish every single day.
Too, okay?
Like, week, not bad.
They're laughing at me there. Because I'm like, what does fish do? Does it...
Fish is just good and healthy. It's a nice source of lean protein, and it gives you omega-3s and omega-6s, which are really great for brain health. But really, it's about, you know, kind of find out where people are at, figure out where we're trying to go, and then start making progress to get there, which... That sounds like a really vague and like marketing answer, and I'm sorry about that, but it's just, it's so highly specific to the individuals and to the teams that I can't give you just one general answer of, oh, we go in and do this, that, and the other thing. We always do a screen. We always do like a physical exam, basically, where we assess some endurance and some strength components that are more specific to gaming.
Yeah, I was gonna say, what are like the most common things that you like recommend to, like, you know, in gaming? Because, you know, I'm pretty sure we have like you said, the posture and certain things that in common. But like,
so everybody thinks of like the healthy things that they can do around gaming as like, what can I do to make, you know, my gaming time at my desk better and healthier? When in reality, that's only a very small part of what goes into health and performance. A lot more of it is what you're doing in your outside of your gaming time. So are you getting consistent movement? Are you drinking enough water throughout the day? Are you, you know, eating a decently balanced diet? Are you getting enough sleep? Most of us aren't, is probably the answer. What's your mindset like? Are you managing stress and your emotional regulation well, or are you needing some help on that front? What's your relationship like with your teammates? How's your communication going? So there's a lot of points that you can address. And honestly, if I could only get people to address one single thing, I'd tell them to sleep better. And the easiest way to do that, set yourself a routine for going to bed and for waking up. Make it something you do religiously, consistently, always. That way, when you're traveling, when something stressful is going on, you've got this routine that tells your brain, okay, we go to sleep now, and okay, we wake up now. A really easy way to help make sure you're kind of bookending your sleep well. The other one, as hard as it is, put your screens down at least half an hour, preferably a full hour before you go to bed.
No,
now, there is some back and forth on whether it's like the light that causes sleep disruption or just like the getting distracted and absorbed on doom scrolling Twitter on your phone. That's the problem. But either way, if you can put your phone down a little bit longer before bedtime each night, working yourself up to half an hour to 60 minutes, your sleep quality and your sleep quantity are both going to be a lot better. And really, sleep is the single easiest, most impactful thing that we could address. Plus, it's a lot easier to get people to sleep than it is to get them to exercise.
That's true.
So that's always my first sticking point. Go for the sleep above everything else.
Yeah. That's so true. Because there's so many times I could like just stay up and play games and, you know...
We're all guilty of it. It's more about how much sleep you're getting consistently than it is about the hours at which you're getting it. As long as it's regular and consistent, you're good. If you're consistently sleeping from 3 o'clock to, you know, 11 o'clock, good job.
Yeah, good job. I needed that for when Cyberpunk releases. No, I'm kidding. Right? I'm pretty sure
we're human. The goal is make it consistent more often than not.
Yeah. sorry. No, but I really enjoyed having you here. Thank you so much. Is there anything else you want to tell us or you want to share with everyone?
If anybody else has other questions, they're free to reach out to me on Twitter. I'm Kate McGee PT on there as well. C-A-I-T. I know there's 20 different ways to spell Kate. Thanks for having me on. Always love to talk about health performance.
Yes, I would love to have you back after Thanksgiving.
Sure thing. I'll be around.
Just because we're home doesn't mean we're not going to be cooking.
There we go.
But thank you so much for
You're
coming.
You're welcome.
And I really appreciate it.
All right. Have a good one.
Yeah. Oh, my God. That was so fun. Did you get anything there, Nock? You're going to get regular sleep routine going?
Oh, yeah. Oh, sleep's the best, dude. I love sleep. I'm going to have to get more of it.
Don't sleep too much. No, kidding.
Yeah.
I do want to remind you guys that Stevens Esports is sponsored by Rock Bottom Comics and Columbia, Missouri's only, that's the name. I'm reading that wrong. I'm so sorry, Rock Bottom Comics. It's Columbia, Missouri's only full service comic shop. Wow, you guys have comic shops still? No, I'm kidding. But yeah, shout out to them for sponsoring Stevens Esports. That's pretty cool and awesome. I just remembered I have these to wear because they were supposed to be for like my screens, and I haven't been wearing them. I wear them like on and off, but they're super comfy, and they're supposed to block like the blue lights and stuff.
Oh yeah, my mom got me one of those for Christmas one year.
Yeah, it's just like just to pick them up and put them on, yeah. You know. I just want to remind you guys to enter the giveaway in chat. Oh, you have clear ones. I'm sorry, I'm reading chat for a little bit. But yeah, enter the giveaway in chat. It's a Corsair keyboard. Okay, check it out. If you don't want it, if when you win it, let me know. I'm just kidding. But you have up to 1,000 tickets, exclamation tickets, space, and the number of tickets. I suggest start with 100 and just try it 10 times. That's then we can send it to Alley Cat. Yes, definitely. Oh, that was really good. I really love hearing from actual like experts, doctors. We've had a couple of doctors and come through here with interviews about like wellness and health. And it's just really exciting because, you know, they're doing all these studies for gaming and like how we react to things. And they also said did you know this? If you are a gamer, you have great problem solving skills.
Oh yeah, I've read that before.
Yeah,
she was great.
So that's pretty awesome. I learned that doing interviews. Okay. So, but yeah, that was pretty awesome. Oh, there it is, Rock Bottom Comics. Yeah, thank you so much for that sponsorship to college. That's pretty cool. I really like just like hearing all about like esports in college, in high school, because I really wish I had that when I was growing up. I know you're like, this old fart is about to tell a story. No, I'm not gonna tell a story, but no, it's like, this is why I like to do this, because it's just so interesting and so fun. So we're gonna get back into some Overwatch really shortly. I'm not sure if they're ready just yet, but what did you think about the last match? We didn't get to talk about it actually. So it was on Hanamura.
I think it was pretty good. I mean, it's just unfortunate that, I mean, Notre Dame, they were so close. They were so close. I wanted them to cap so bad. Because they just had the beautiful tire in the grab and just unlucky spawns that Stefan was able to get back and clean it up.
Yeah, like they reacted so well, and even when you thought they were gonna like have a little comeback, you know, the well-oiled Illithia machine.
Yeah,
they just really know how to react. And I mean, I really love how Notre Dame is playing as well. They are playing very teamy. I mean, the last time Stevens played on here, the other team, they played kind of more like to their strengths of like the character, because they knew those characters. It was like almost sometimes they would separate. I love that Notre Dame waits for their teammates, you know, like they'll wait. They know how to like, you know, come back together. You could kind of tell they're regrouping, and I kind of like that. So we're going to your favorite map next.
Oh, let's go.
So we're going to be entering King's Row. And so what do you like about this map, and what are you looking forward to?
I just think the way that this map is set up, there's just so many different ways. I mean, just for first point alone, where you can walk in and have a bunch of different paths to cap the point. And if you're on defense, there's a bunch of different places you can hold. So, I don't know. I hope to see some Rein Zarya, but I'm not sure if we'll get that lucky. But that's my favorite tank line drone on this map, for sure.
Wow. Yeah, I really like to see Zarya on this map. I think you might see, but maybe not. But yeah, it's a really fun map. I like playing this on Lucio as well, because I could just run up the walls and kind of be, you know, just bloop people out of the way, kind of a thing, to kind of make way for the tanks if I'm attacking. If we're holding the point, it's just everybody's there. It's like a really nice size space. I don't have to worry about like looking for, you know, Junkrat in the corner over there type of thing. It's just, I think King's Row is just always going to be that map. And like I said, it's the classic,
Yeah, I just, it's just the best designed map in the game, and it seems like every single point is just, it's really versatile, it's really friendly to a lot of different comps, and it actually seems like this map that Stevens and Notre Dame, they're actually mixed in, so it's more of like a pug.
Oh, so we're going to the pug. All right. Yeah.
Oh my. Blue team, they're on a bulldozer comp here. Oh no.
I wonder if they're just doing using the different coaches.
Yeah, I don't know.
We'll ask later. We'll drag Lippy in here for our post game interview. But this is pretty cool. And they were right at the door. Okay. Alright.
Oh, yeah.
See, I was gonna say, I wonder if they're gonna run up to the door like we saw before, and sure enough, they did.
Yeah, the comp that they're on right now, it really excels at just, just hugging the spawn doors. I mean, there's nothing this Widow can do. Look at the shields. There's no way. Oh. Looks like they're
right.
Yeah,
red team found a way around, and now, oh. And I really like that reaction. We get some hammy.
Oh yeah, it looks like the blue team is just gonna be able to bulldoze them on the point to be able to hold this. Yep, for sure.
Alright, Hammy is high to the top there. I think the ride is kind of looking for Hammy. But what a nice reaction, because somehow the red team found its way around. And then he was like, okay, we gotta go back. And
yep.
And look at this. Great ult from Tor. Just kind of picture them coming back. And look at
Lath is just in their backline. Goodness, they better be careful. She's got mines. Oh, there's gonna be huge mines coming out here for sure. There they are.
Oh,
she gets Smithsonian. Huge pick.
I don't even know if they realize that
Amy's
like right behind them.
They just let the ball into their backline.
Yeah. Rent free, let's go.
I think they'll be able to hold though. Yeah, they will.
Yeah, this is a great standoff. And I mean, this just shows in the player's ability to kind of hold and react to just even, it was just so close. Again, these reactions are just so phenomenal, and I love watching them. Mm-hmm. But you would have thought the Hammy had I love this guy.
I know. Oh my! I think Red Team's got this. They've got two picks, pushing that Rein down.
Oh, and down the super.
Goodness, Silver popping for ult.
Literally anyone's game. We're gonna see who holds out in this big push.
Yeah.
I think you're right. I think Red Team is gonna be pulling this one out.
Like, I think they have it, but okay, yeah, now Blue's backing out. Okay, good. Goodness.
Yeah, that one was really close. I didn't want to call it right away because it was just such a great battle, but they were getting those picks, and that's what you kind of need. You need to get like those quick picks for them not to react so well, because they react so well under pressure. And that was a really great push. Now we're gonna get the payload. Cool.
Yeah, and I think Red's gonna be able to keep the momentum here because they've got three ults.
There is the Reaper ult.
Maybe not, that's huge.
Yeah, it takes out the Lucio, the Zen, and the Gem Strike.
There's more.
Down goes Steve. Oh, is this a team kill? Is someone hiding?
Yeah, Lap is in the backline again.
Oh. And this is a great reaction to them taking the point. They're just gonna hold the payload here now.
Yeah, I mean, the comp that they're on, Bulldozer, really just excels at not giving space and just, holding really aggressively.
Yeah, it's really fun to see. My DPS main Torb. you know, sometimes you just gotta be petty with all, and that was
for sure. Oh my, that's huge! That's huge! Oh my goodness, the May ult. Oh, they'll be able to get this for sure.
Oh wow, and the payload is moving after those. Oh, I don't even count how many ults that was, but that was an amazing reaction after the Tor blocked the door with the ult. They just came around and they're like, we're gonna take this, we're gonna do big push, and yeah. So now I believe, oh, I think they just switched colors. Is that what it was? Yes, over Dipper Smithsonian. Not really. Oh no, it is mixed up now because Lapalos is over here and Luffy is over here. Okay, so we're gonna do blue team, red team. That's totally fine. Cause I know, like, both these teams, they're super nice and they're having a ball just playing like this. So,
oh yeah.
All right, and then another. So you kind of want to stop it right here. You don't want it to get to this checkpoint. So we're seeing some big, big reaction to the push here. Mm-hmm. And I love how Blue Team is reacting. It's just so good.
Yeah, it seems like every single time they engage, they're using an ult to just really make sure they win the fight and they're securing it. That's really good.
Stay out of my room. Yeah, I like this play a lot.
Lap is just rolling around in the backline again. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, and they have 30 seconds. Kind of in their favor. We're gonna see what this last push does. If they can get the checkpoint here. Lap goes with a big dive. And big ult. And down goes Tem. Oh no. But Tor did get that ult on. He's got 10 seconds remaining. I believe that's true.
I think. Oh no! Get on the point! Get on the point!
Oh, there it is. That overtime pending, and here we go.
I think red team's gonna be able to really get this point. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, they're looking for this big push, and it's just solo Ryan out here. Oh no, and the payload is moving. Good job, red team. You're just pushing the payload forward. See, you love to see it. This is what you need. Now you're resetting the clock. You have more time. But blue team has to regroup and stop them here. Only one more checkpoint left till the end of the game. But yeah, I mean, I love this. I kind of like the mix-up a little bit better because we're seeing the back and forth. And I believe everyone's just like learning from each other. And here we go. We're gonna see the big Rhyme ult come in here. I'm not sure if this is the big push, but it's looking like it.
Yeah, I think Lap's team is just. I mean, they're really using their ults to their advantage here. They are playing really aggressive.
And there goes the big ult. And stay back, stay back.
Oh, that was a huge brig rally. That was absolutely instrumental in them just getting their defense back and holding this.
Yeah, but that was also a big push for the payload because they got around that corner really quick. Oh, yeah. So hopefully they can kind of push it back a little bit. Kind of want to like hold this corner for as long as you can. I think they could push it back to over there, but yeah. See, this is gonna be a big choke point now. This is the fun part. This is the fun part. Oh, yeah. It's gonna be a big, big battle. Oh, and here comes the hammy.
That shatter. Oh my goodness, Tem22 comboing with Alithia. Oh, it's a massacre. Oh my goodness. Yeah, that was a good round.
That was
I know, right? They were really fighting tooth and nail the whole time. Both teams. Initiating
the match. I actually didn't realize that was the only one round. That was fun. Very back and forth. What did you like with this match? Because it was very back and forth.
I mean, both teams, they were definitely using their ults, and they were using them well. And I mean, we just had that Lap especially, she was always making space with her mines. She would get behind the enemy team, lay them down so her team could push in, and that was, you know, pretty much won them the fight every single time she did that. But then you had, you know, the blue team, they were playing really close together. They were really capitalizing on any ult that they used. So, I mean, it's just anyone's game right now.
Yeah, and I'm excited for this round too, because it was just so back and forth. You know, first they got the point and the big push after, you know, the big, you know, they reacted well to that. They came back, kind of took over the table again, and then they reacted to that, got a big push, and then took over the table again. It's just was really a great back and forth. It came really cool to like be in these matches, even when you play Overwatch.
Oh yeah.
But yeah, like you said, I like the alt holding, the alt
turning. Yeah, it looks like Blue Team's trying to get a sim teleport here. I think on the statue? I could be wrong. I don't know where they're going. Oh, never mind. They're on the high ground. They're on the high ground. If they can get their bash set up on that high ground, I think they really just get this point. Oh, yup. Oh, that is just the worst. Oh my goodness. Yep, Blue Team definitely holding the space here on the point, making sure that they can secure this with a baffle. Flamestar is going to be taking out Maxi. I've got your finger. What a beautiful cap. I was a little worried in the beginning, but they made the teleport, got the bash in high ground, and they took a point.
Yeah, I don't even think they noticed that they made the teleport because they were trying to like take down the entry point.
So yeah,
it was like a little bit too late, and then they had Bastion set up perfectly. So here we go. We're gonna see a nice push here.
Hello.
Oh, okay. Now this is gonna be a little hard for the red team to retake because now they're super set up and they're teleporting. Yeah. What is this? This is unheard of. My goodness.
I didn't know pirate ship was still around.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Anything for the win, right? Oh, beautiful sim wall. With Temple on a great charge. In the setup on the high ground. Amazing. Yeah, just double shield, Bash and Baptiste. Like, they're really gonna have to. Yeah. Oh, these things are looking grim.
And I mean, they have 5 minutes to burn at this point. It's a torture.
Yeah. Oh, the pressure!
You're like, we gotta hold for 5 minutes. Let's get it together.
Oh, Battlehawk's off the map. That could be crucial pick. They might be able to take this. Oh no, the Bastion set up on the high ground. Someone stop him! Oh no. Beautiful shatter again from 10 point. Ho coming out from Shadow Dragon. She's keeping her team up. Yeah. Yeah, I know. Super Wolf getting a double kill on the Baptiste's Bastion high ground. Actually game changing. My gosh, they were living up there, rent free.
Yeah, and that was right. So they went down to the Sorry, everybody's like, who's toes? Sigma.
I think red team, they've gotten over the hump. They've gotten the Bastion off the payload and off the high ground. I think all they need to do now is just really focus on holding this point. And I think that it's still winnable for sure.
Yeah, and great play by the Junkrat. I don't think the blue team really noticed that he was like in the cut there. As Junkrat, not in front of the team. And...
Beautiful picks again by the DPS Flame Star and Super Wolf here.
And I really like what their DPS is doing on the red team. They're getting those picks, and that's what they need.
Exactly.
I can't hold forever!
I recommend moving behind my barrier.
So is blue team waiting for,
much obliged.
I think they're trying to figure out what they're gonna do.
Yeah,
I mean... We've got a lot
of
wolves.
Do you see the setup by the red team? I really like
that. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's great. Huge Bog, huge Ash. Ults coming out from both sides. Hem is just unstoppable with these shatters. Every shatter is not like two or three people. That's not lost yet. Reempire coming out on Super Wolf here. Yep, gonna use the hit. Beautiful pick. Silver Dipper in the absolute back line. Oh my. Fully charged beam. Oh no.
Oh man. This is such a great reaction. I mean, we saw them take the break there for a little second to kind of gather their thoughts. And I mean, it worked out, right?
Oh, yeah. I think Silver Dipper, she pushed in and she put her wall on the point. And I don't know if Flamestar got two kills with her bot, but if you've got a fully charged Sim just blasting down the tanks and she's the Sim has wall up, it's just, it's over. It's hard to win that team fight. Great gameplay from both sides though, for sure.
Yeah, was that the master buying Alithia at work?
Probably.
But that was real. I mean, that was really competitive. I love doing these because this is like an all-female thing. I do need to mention that. If you guys don't know what the Hive is about, it's about getting women into esports. We help high school and collegiate schools. These are all female. I'm really excited always to do these. They're so fun to watch because they're so competitive. And like you said, it's just, you know, a good time. Like, everyone is super nice.
Like, everyone's super nice, but like, they have no problem finding you in game and taking you down, and they will do it, and they will so well for sure. You know, it's great.
Yeah, I found that out as well. I just made one mention of a 1v1, you know, after a stream, you know, but I want to remind you guys to enter the giveaway in chat. It's for a nice keyboard, a Corsair K60 RGB. Is it RGB keyboard? Mm-hmm. The winners will be picked in about 30 minutes or so. So make sure you enter. Thank you to Corsair for sponsoring these high streams. Also to NFL Alumni and ASTV. Also, Stevens College is sponsored by Rock Bottom Comics in Missouri. They're a full service comic book shop. Go check them out. And when you go, you say thank you for sponsoring Stevens College. Also wear a mask. But yeah, that was really fun. I really enjoy, I mean, you played in the first scrim. You know, what is that dynamic like? Give us like the inside information. Is it just like we're having fun, or are you guys actually making like play calls? Like, we gotta crush them.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's, you know, definitely everyone's having fun, but we're also like calming. We're like, okay, what ult are we gonna use this fight? Like, what do you guys want to play? Like, oh, I want to go behind them and shatter, you know? Like, it's pretty competitive. I mean, everyone's trying their best, and it just makes really great games to watch.
Yeah, I mean, as a caster watching like these, like I said, I have so much, like, it's like a huge smile on my face. That's why sometimes I'm not saying anything, because I'm like, everyone can hear you smile, girl. But but it's just such a good time. And, you know, we could always, and I love doing this, that, you know, it's like on Twitch and everything, because everybody in chat is also enjoying it. And they're like, oh man, they're really throwing down. Like, some of my community members come out and I'm just like, wow, like, they're better than you, Allie. I'm like, of course they're better than me. But yeah, I'm not trying to pick any fights or anything, but they, yeah, like, even my community members are like, wow, they really like, I like watching that. And mm-hmm. that's, you know, if only women ruled the world, it would be amazing. Yeah.
Yes, for sure.
Stop reminding people to enter the giveaway. It lowers my chances. You know, just, I like the smiley face on the end. So yeah, reminder, enter the giveaway. You have up to 1,000 tickets. Silver Dipper says, why every time I come back, you guys are on my point of view? You're making plays. I'm sorry.
Silver, you gotta chill out.
Don't yell at us. Yell at Char. But yeah, shout out to our production team. He's doing great. I say team, but it's really like one person.
I know.
But he's doing amazing. Shout out to Bayou, who's in the chat under the Esports CCP. I like to like give credit to everybody who works here. Everybody's like super professional and friendly. Mm-hmm. And yeah, it's just always just fun to do this. No, nobody knows about Char. Ha 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 ha. The hidden production master. Well, now they know. But yeah, I like working with him as well. He's super fun, super chill. And sometimes when the plays go off, this is how you know how good the Overwatch matches are. Char is watching and he's like in our ear. When the plays go off and they do something super cool, you hear him go, oh my God. Yeah, yeah. You kind of hear him a little bit. He's super cool. So yeah. But yeah, make sure you guys follow the channel, follow the Esports CCP Twitch channel, and make sure you follow them on Twitter. They have a lot of tournaments and things coming up as well, not just the Hive initiative here, but they do have collegiate esports and, you know, some high school and military as well. So make sure you guys check that out. If only you could hear him on it. I tried to make him co-cast and he said no. Knock was my wing.
Yes, a little scuffed replacement, but it's okay. Maybe we should do a Char interview.
What is it like to hear Allie giggle 1,000 times? I'm kidding. All right, so where are we going? El Dorado, is that what it is?
Mm-hmm. Dorado.
I feel it's Dorado. I always say El Dorado, and everybody's like, it's Dorado. I'm sorry. Yeah. So this map, I will never forget this. Picture it, Sicily. It was like our first Hive stream, first map, Dorado. What do they do? They walk up to the door and we're casters. We're just talking like, oh my God, haha, we're all girls. We're gonna enjoy this Overwatch map. Mm-hmm. And Lithia's team just walks up to the door and like, murders everybody. And we were like, what just happened? We don't know what just happened.
That's like her favorite strat is to just in your spawn, you're dead. Have fun. Respawn again. We'll do it again.
And everyone's mouths literally dropped and we were like, oh, okay. So we're serious out here. Okay, let's do this. But shout out to both options as well. But yeah, this is what? Super fun.
Attack is incoming.
I'm like, watch the pain. But yeah, this Dorada gives me PTSD a little bit because it's just like, we all were like, okay.
I think I'm looking for it.
Yeah,
I think got a pirate ship again, but Alithia's team is choosing to hold close.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people are familiar with this like type of play. You kind of get them before they hit the corners.
Oh, huge! Huge pick.
Yeah, that was like a oh, there comes the raise for I kind of missed the
Oh, I know. That was so much fun.
It was just such a buzzkill, and I feel like I just enjoyed it so much. I didn't even play this game. Like, it was just a thing when you, like, kill a whole team, you know, you take them all out, and then you just hear, you know.
Heroes never die.
Yeah, and everybody's up. Oh, my work was in vain. But they're still moving this halo here, and we love it. The pirate ship is perfect, and I love the Orisa Sigma.
I mean, Blue Team's just really gonna have to group up and try and get this bash off the cart. Oh wait, that is an actually massive mail. Oh, it freezes three.
And Blue Team is making kicks here.
An amazing play. That Blizzard just allowed, you know, the Widow to just get those picks. They were standing still. What a great way to get the
bash off. What was that, four? I'm not even sure. I missed the count there, but wow, that was a game-changing. And like, as you can see, Red has to regroup and come back and get their payload.
What's this?
Yeah, I mean, Red Team, they're in a good spot, but they're really gonna have to use their ult well because, I mean, Blue still has a couple, so we'll see. Lab trying to take a flank here and get a pick before the fight starts. Oh, for sure.
Lithia on May, love to see it. I didn't think we were gonna see it, but we did.
She's at 66 already, so.
60 seconds.
Oh, there's a minute left. What? There's a minute left.
I was gonna say, I'm not sure. Well, they haven't even been to the first checkpoint yet, so this is like a huge. Probably one of the big fish red team. Or is it making the. Oh, and. Big Orisa. Oh, I didn't even realize Orisa ulted there.
Yeah, that was a really good use of ults to just, you know, get a couple picks. Oh. Definitely.
Misdirection. Might have hit a wall or something. We didn't see it, chat. Don't worry about it.
Okay, so now that Red Team's back on Pirate Ship, Blue Team's gonna have to think some strats to get him off again. Probably gonna be able to do this coming out, if I'm not mistaken.
I mean, the pirate ship isn't foolproof. You definitely can get around it and do your picks, and that's how you kind of like feel for
freezing four.
And maybe this is why they did the game. I didn't even know they realized they were gonna be pirate ship. Like, May is really good for that as well.
Yeah, it was such a good mail, but Super Wolf just came in and got the picks, and Kiki Dragon got a res off, so it just was all in vain.
Yeah, and that's why you love Mercy on your team, because when your main DPS is done, you got somebody to pick up. Even with big tanks, like Orisa,
oh yeah. It's so. I was gonna say, it's just so game-changing when you get a really good res off of a key person on your team. The fight's just... it's a player back that doesn't have to, you know, take 15 seconds to watch back. It's a huge shatter by Destination.
The whole from the blue team is just really good right now. And they're reacting really great with just like, even with the red team really getting the pirate ship together. I mean, are they going to do that? Mm-hmm. Now they got to walk all the way up here.
Touch fire. Taking off.
Yeah, this is going to be really difficult for them to get back on that payload.
It looks like they're going inside.
Yeah, that'd be a really smart thing to do if they were to get high ground, and I think they are. Definitely risking it.
Ah, they do go around.
Oh, Lizard, that's huge. Oh,
oh no.
And the revive.
Oh, that was a huge, huge Sigma ult from Smithsonian. That was a really good idea to rotate around. I just think, unfortunately, not the entire team was on the same page, so it took them a little longer to rotate, but I mean, they almost had it. That would have been a beautiful...
Yeah, like, and blue team had their their alts as well as reses. I mean, those... I was just like, as soon as somebody went down, we thought it was, you know, game-changing. That res would come right back.
Yeah.
So that was really clutch for them. And I love the teamwork. I mean, like I said, I love when I play Orisa, I love having a Mercy because I don't have to make that walk back. You know?
Yeah, for sure.
But yeah, that was really great matchup though. I love the back and forth. I mean, it's really anyone's game. And that was a really great round. I'm interested to see what this big team is going to be like and how Team Charles is offering. Hopefully it's not like, you know, super quick.
My red team took a little long to pick their comp, so they're going to be at a little disadvantage here. And it looks like red team's gonna be playing Rush, which might work well into the comp that blue team's running right now, so we'll see. Alithia's on ball. Let's go. My huge picks from blue. Double kill on ball. This is gonna be huge for the momentum. Oh my goodness!
Yeah, and they're picking them off right before they even can.
Oh
yeah. is hanging back with the payload, which is pretty cool. I think it's Smithsonian and Zara. Zarya was there for a little bit, but yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, hopefully. Yeah, hopefully red team can make a play here. This is the last fight. They have a couple of. Oh no! Super Sailor gets picked. Lap gets another kill on Kiki Dragon.
Who could play Star and Lapis on the same team?
Right? Oh, huge minds on point. Oh, finds Dusty.
Unfortunate.
He's not lost yet. We do have beat here, so KC needs to stay in there good. Huge beat. And like the Widow. Someone's gonna get on the Widow in the back line. Get her. Oh no.
But, oh my god,
it's so good. It was, and you know, red team was, they found a couple of picks, but I mean, that res came out again. It was a huge mind on a cart.
Oh, we got some Wrecking Ball, Lithia. Can't miss it, huh? Can't. I thought it was going to be your mate. I'm like, I thought it was going to be your mate, huh? Good job, Lydia. Wow, Flamestar as well. I'm surprised you didn't get it. Or Lapilos. Also, take Lapilos and Flamestar off the same team. Thank you.
Yeah, they're a little bit of a dynamic duo for sure.
I mean, Flamestar, I mean, even when they were playing respective teams, Flamestar was basically like, I think Flamestar does well with flanking, and it looks just. Mm-hmm. Just DPSing, you know, doing the DPS thing. What about Rathalos? Wrong game said. That's Monster Hunter. Flame is the best. Yeah, like Flamestar has really been out there, as well as Alithia, of course, with the Pog. We did see some Alithia May, which I really liked. She had the big play with... the freeze with the ult, sorry. But yeah.
That was great. Yeah. I mean, and it's crazy to see a Widow flank and do well flanking, because I know if I try and flank on Widow, sometimes the pressure gets to me, like I'm supposed to get a kill and then I just can't aim. And then I die. But she was doing a really great job of getting picks, and her positioning was impeccable, so.
Yeah, I think Lapilos was on Widow, wasn't it? Or was it Flamestar? I don't even know. At one point they switched.
Yeah, Flamestar was the Widow on attack, and then I think Lap was the Widow on defense.
Take them off the teams. Oh, man. Also, the Ana play was really good. Ana hugged the payload in the last round. I thought that was a great play because they were picking them off. Most of the team was built up front. I think Zarya kind of stayed back, and they were getting like really quick picks, which really helped because, I mean, what, 5 versus 3, you know, works out in your favor. Mm-hmm. The big Sigma ult as well. There's just so many plays in that you just could pick out. The big Sigma ult when they were going around. I really thought the Bastion had it to kind of pick them up a little bit. But yeah, the big Sigma ult. I mean, you guys do a great job just holding your ults for like these amazing, like even like not even pushes, but just to hold off.
Yeah, I think a lot of like, everyone's doing a really good job at using their ult at the right time, for
and
sure.
And together. Yeah.
Yeah.
We've seen a couple of them go off together. So just in case, you thought it was that one, you know. Mm-hmm. Are we ready to pull this winner? Okay, so last chance for you guys to enter is a Corsair giveaway. Shout out to Corsair for sponsoring the Hive. I hope you guys have been watching these streams because they're so amazing. The NFL alumni as well as ESTV, but right now Corsair gave us a keyboard and I'm keeping it. There's no giveaway. No, I'm kidding. we're going to be giving away the K60. It looks so good. I mean, we have like, you know, little talks during the week leading up to this. And usually I get like what we're giving away on Thursday. And I'm just like, so I went into the box. I'm like, oh, what are we giving away? And they showed me the picture and I was like, oh, that looks good.
Oh, yeah.
Really? Yeah. I was like, that looks really good. So, oh, did they pull it?
It looks like Fill Up My Cup has won the giveaway. Woohoo!
Look at this chance. It's 3.55. Yeah. Wow.
Do you guys do giveaways every week?
If I'm not mistaken? We have for the past couple. Oh. I have to do the wave.
Yeah. Okay.
yeah, we have. I think. Did we do one the first week? I'm not sure we did one the first week, but the week after the first one we have. Mm-hmm. So yeah.
So, but yeah, guys. Yeah, make sure you know you tune in next time because the Hive does a lot of really cool stuff, and they do, and you know, might be another giveaway. I'm not sure. I'm just a filler, but.
Just a filler. We'll get some stuff for you. I actually got these because of the Hive streams with Esports CCP. But shout out to Esports CCP. Make sure you guys follow them on Twitter. It's Esports Career and Career Pathways. So if you ever want to work in, you know, esports, they're a good organization to follow, and make sure you follow the stream. But yeah, I got these because of that. They also gave me a cool sweatshirt. It's on my Instagram. It's on my Instagram bio. But yeah, everybody's like, what? No, I'm kidding. But yeah, I got those. They sent like a nice little care package, or got that in a sweatshirt. I was really excited.
Mm-hmm.
So shout out to Esports CCP and the Hive. And we're also gonna, well, I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say. Never mind. I was gonna say something about the glasses, but I'm not sure if they told me in confidence, but make sure you come back and tune in. And also, if you're a player, you know, you might get some perks as well. And that's all I can say, I guess. But yeah, they were really nice to talk to as well. But, you know, but he's like, oh no, she's spilling the beans. what map
attackers
is
incoming in 30 seconds.
Oh, okay. I don't remember. Route 66, right?
Route 66, yeah.
Okay. I'm like, am I bugging? I was going to call it the diner map. No.
There is a diner.
Let's see if they switched players here. Oh, wait. That person's actually not playing right now. So I'm guessing they're bringing in different players. In, which I love to see.
Attackers incoming.
So we got Kinky Dragon, Shadow Dragon, Silver Dizzler. Battle Hawk is really good as well.
Yeah, I'm really eager to see Maxi Waxi get some really good ults here because they've done a really good job at using their ults in
the
air.
I'm not sure. Was Kiki Dragon the Mercy?
Yeah, she was one of the Mercies for sure. Her Mercy is really good. She's really good Mercy.
Alright, so we're already getting into some
here. Oh. Big pick by Silverwolf on the Risa, but Kiki comes out with the rest! Cute!
I
know!
Gotta love being a Arisa player, but they're down with Battle Hawk. That Mercy! Oh, sorry, I'm not sure you guys are talking about that. Alright, here we go.
Blue team set up on the payload, but they're just gonna have to be careful that they don't get hooked by armor here. Come with fire. Oh, big pig. Oh my
god. I feel like that's a great thing for
a it would have, in theory, it was a good idea, but, you know, it had that shrink, so. didn't quite pan out.
They did take down the I feel like it's their communication issues right now. That was Roadhog, thank you. I'm sorry. What kind of Roadhog
do
they have, okay?
Yeah, Roadhog. It's the worst feeling when you get hooked, and it's just like, come on, man. Please don't hook me. Anyone else but me.
And look at this, it's just a standstill here, but each team are getting picked, but they're getting picked and coming back so quick. It's just the same standoff.
Yeah.
This is just so competitive. I really love it. Oh, big hook. Oh, man, that was... Yeah. Also, Maxi. That wow.
Yeah.
That is kind of popping off here.
Yeah, that was a super, super good bongo by Ally Rogue, I think. Yeah. Just really allowed Illy to get that extra damage in. A huge tire from Super Wolf! Super Wolf, every single time she tires, it's a guaranteed like 2 or 3 kills. I really don't know what to say. Yeah. Tem just got a huge Sigma ult. Red team's got a couple ults here, they're using them on the tanks. Huge boop from Ormer. I think Red team might be able to get this. Oh, there's a Zen flanking. Oh no, someone turn around.
No! No! Lipkin, please!
Oh, Ormer, get the Lipkin back. Good job, Ormer. And it's a baby D.Va. Risa off here with Ana. Oh no. Yeah, Red definitely having the advantage of response. Able to get back, get that bongo off. Cinnamon kills, get Flamestar. Huge pick, Battlehawk. Red's still cleaning up the fight. Huge. Yeah, I think Red definitely has this point.
What a play by Red team. I mean, that was really cool. I mean, everybody, they were getting, like I said, they were getting 1 or 2 picks, but everyone was kind of coming back because it was just such a backseat.
Yeah. It was a really good job by the tanks. Just, and I mean, Baby D.Va made sure that she stayed alive so that she could get her mech again. And I mean, hey, it worked out. She was able to get back. And let's just see if they're able to.
Huge game changing play.
Yeah. Nope. Warmer gets the Orisa. Huge. Fortunately, for once, Super Wolf doesn't get anyone with their fire.
They're keeping them
really good spacing,
really
moving
the back here, and I like that.
Yeah.
I'm not sure they noticed that Reaper up top.
Yeah. Armor kisses out the Reaper. Oh, Flamestar will get Silver Dipper. A little too aggressive there. Nanoing the Reaper. Oh, yep. That's a beautiful ult. The counter nano on Armor. Oh, no. Yeah. Risa, Battlehawk, definitely getting down here. Red team really needs to reset.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, for sure. Get you
healed. Taking down the teleporter there, and yeah, they get a nice hold here. And I mean, the reaction test has been really on point.
Oh.
Who paused the game?
I think. Yeah.
I think they're checking to make sure everyone is there.
I just had a bunch of people go offline on my friends list, so I think there's might be a server issue. Yeah, I just had like 10 people go offline at once. Oh my.
All right, so yeah, they're just doing like a team check here. It was positive. They're like, who's here? It's like attendance. Hey, you gotta love it. Like I said, everybody's always in good spirits, so they want to make sure everyone is here and no one is offline. But yeah, I think there was like a server thing where it says people went offline.
Mm-hmm. Nope. Fortunate. Jeff pulled the plug, apparently. Oops.
I'm just gonna type blame Char. I'm just kidding. All right, we look like we're going back in. Here we go.
Yep. We're still here? Everyone?
Okay, oh, yeah. Getting up on the
Kiki with a pick on Super Wolf, but a huge signal by 1022.
They're trying to hold here.
Big symbol. Oh, the tire's gonna be big. Yup, finding Piggy Dragon. It's just silver on the point. Yeah.
I don't know if Anna can touch. No.
Beautiful hold. Beautiful hold.
I am unstoppable.
Yeah, I mean, considering that they almost, considering that they almost got, you know, held at that first corner, I mean, they made it, like, got past first point, so, I mean, this is definitely super winnable.
Yeah, I mean, you can definitely hold right before the first checkpoint. I mean, I feel like with Route 66, majority tries to hold before that first checkpoint. But yeah, I mean, that was a great reaction. They got the halo way further than what it seemed like it was gonna go, especially with the beginning of the match being like a standoff for a little bit. But just great reactions from each team. And again, I feel like they focus, you know, key points. They know who's doing what. They saw Kiki getting res off, and definitely. I'm pretty sure she only got a couple more. But yeah, you saw Kiki go down a couple of times. He definitely wanted the mercy, you know. It kind of sucks to kind of focus heal, especially when you're the healer. That's just me talking to people.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Especially when I'm playing and I'm on my Collision team, I'm calling the healers first. Like, they have to be the first ones to go down. Because, I mean... Yeah, you get rid of the sustain, it's you know, get rid of the tanks, and it's an easy win here, but let's see. No shield tank from blue team.
Yeah, this is definitely gonna be a fun game, yeah? Yeah, D.Va and Roadhog, can't stand, but it's okay.
Yeah, I think blue team's like, they're definitely focusing on damage. They have the Zen, they've got Junkrat, like, this could work.
Yeah, I mean, it's nice to have D.Va, because you have to dive, clear out, you know, build up as much as possible to clear out when needed. I think it's kind of cool. I was gonna say, have Kiki with Battlehawk. I think that's why they kind of focus those two team, because I mean, we saw like in the beginning of the first round, Battlehawk went down and he was right there in red, you know. So they were like, what? No, this is not good.
Big Val. His bat field is just so game changing. Like, if he can like cancel a D.Va bomb, for example, perfectly, I mean, that's huge.
Yeah. And I mean, that's why he's probably out there right now. But yeah, that's pretty good.
From
light. We got Zarya and Orisa for the tank on the right team. What do you think about that? I know you're do you like having, you know, what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, I normally, I kind of just play off of my main tank, but I mean, I would normally probably play a Hog or a Sigma with Orisa, but I mean, this Zarya seems to be working just fine. Big drink. It's a level 5 skill still! Oh my goodness!
Your reaction is so low. Oh my god. I don't think I was ready for that today. I'm personally in love with that.
Oh yeah.
This is so mobile.
Yeah. Oh, that's a bump. Oh, cute! If Silver gets her wall off, I don't want to do this.
Yeah!
Oh, that's a massive grab.
Oh, that's insane!
But it's crazy because with either team, even if they lose someone, it's not lost. Like, half the time they still win, you know? It's amazing. Both teams were just really stellar at holding that corner and breaking through in an overtime fight.
Yeah, and them reacting to each other, to each team's ult is just phenomenal. And like you said, even if they kick off, I mean, we were seeing the other matches, they kick off corner two, kind of so this, they're putting off one and two, and it's still, you know, in the game, they're still
Super Wolf. Oh, this is gonna be a big tire. I feel it. Again, just two. It's just unstoppable. My goodness.
Leave me alone. But that was so huge. He did. And I believe Zen got caught in that as well. Yeah. I mean, just the placement of that. I don't even know if they knew they were around each other. But I mean, the placement of that red tire was just so good. And it looked like,
it's not lost yet. They're going in. They're touching. It's a big Valk. We have Bongo, but Battlehawk is hacked, unfortunately. Oh no.
I mean, you just gotta hold for a minute. You could do this. I mean,
he gets the res off on Battlehawk. Battlehawk Bongos. Red team's getting picked. And red team will hold it. My goodness. There's a minute left. Can they do it again?
Yeah, this one you want to set up and strategize, right? Like,
yeah, because I mean, yeah, blue team, I mean, they've got, what, 5 ults coming in this next fight? I mean, yeah, red team's, they're going to have to get some picks here or positioning or something.
We're getting a big team battle in the next couple of seconds.
Oh, goodness.
But I mean, I feel like they're going to have to go here. Yeah.
No one dies. Good hiding behind the payload. Oh no.
That was so good.
No, just blue team just had, I mean, that was a big EMP. I'm pretty sure Sombra Flamestar EMP'd six people. It was huge.
Wow, Lithia. Wow, okay, all right. Team
oh my. There's nowhere to run.
Chat, like, you want to fight, Allie? You want to fight? No. Wow.
That was nuts.
I'm not eating a pepperoni. I mean, we might have time for one more if they rush it.
Yeah.
So hurry up and get into it. But what an awesome game. That, again, another back and forth. We love the payloads, right? Like, I think I like it for like those big team matches. Kind of get a moment to set up, but what a great reactions to like seeing how I think they reacted very well to Kiki with the reses because yeah. She was getting those off really well, and I was like, oh man. But again, they focus Kiki, focus the Zen.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah,
I mean both teams did. It's actually crazy because they both got stuck at that corner. They both got through it in overtime. They both capped. Then they both pushed it all the way to the end. But then they got stopped again. It was just overtime push. I mean, ults were coming out everywhere. It was crazy.
Yeah. And I mean, this is why we love Overwatch. It's competitive. Mm-hmm. You get those big team battles. You get to see the ults. You get to see, even playing solo, like solo queuing and stuff, you still love those big like moments where you and your team kind of recover. And yeah, that was a great hold. I don't even know who won that.
Oh, wait, I actually have no idea. Like, I don't know.
Because they're just mixing as we're talking right now. I'm like, you guys are just having fun out there. I love it. By the way, shout out to Stevens College and Notre Dame High School. It's just an all-girls high school, I believe. You guys are so amazing and so phenomenal. I love when we do these. So I'm not reading chat. I'm going to put this mod sword on and delete all this Allie versus Nock talk.
What is not happening?
No, don't.
Did you? Then you want a 1v1?
No, I'm okay. I'm actually really good. I'm here. I got my pizza. Okay, I'm good. My hands are greasy, chat.
Oh, is that the excuse?
It might be. It just might be. My hands are greasy. all right, we're gonna get into this last matchup. Let's see who's here. Destination Alley Rogue, Flamestar, Super Wolf, Olivia, Tem. And then we got Kiki, Shadow Dragon. How do you say that name?
Quarmia.
Oh, Valhawk, Silver Dipper, Maxi Waxi. You guys are all phenomenal tonight, so.
We have a Rhyndzar, Maxi Waxi, and Battlehawk. I'm feeling it. They've got this for sure. Come on.
Alright, who are you going for, chat? Red or blue? They have this new thing for the
best player. They do?
Yeah.
My both?
Oh, yeah.
Huge pin! Maxi Wax is finding destination! Oh my crazy. Oh, I think Red has this for sure.
To the red team.
Just a little bit. I mean, Ryan Zarya, I can't. It's just so good. And another pin! Are you kidding me?
Oh, man. Oh, Maxi Waxi. Maxi Waxi was like, this is the last one. Wow. That's great.
Like, you thought I was on a tank, so I'm playing DPS right now.
Yeah.
Oh my. Wait, but losing gets two picks? Flamestar with a co? What happened?
Flamestar is just so good. I mean, this is a Mora right now. Are you DPS Mora right now? Oh, wow. I'm on fire. Wow, that was so tough. We caught that on camera. Pick the Kiki dragon. Oh, no. Kiki is also playing Mora as well, so we really want to see it. Oh, let's go home now. Really am. You guys aren't holding back.
Wait, for the huge shatter! Oh my, but Illy flies in with a beat. It's Super Bowl tires and finds two again. Unbelievable.
She didn't need a blue team.
Moira.
Oh, and blue team heard what you were saying. And is now.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know, they're holding this port for pretty strong. Come on, Max, relax. You got this.
Unbelievable.
Not Char trying to comment.
I don't know what to say. There were so many times where I thought red team, but they were so close to getting it, but then just an ult came out from blue and it was over.
Yo, Allie, share. No! Pizza is life. It's actually my first time eating pizza for like the whole year. But yeah, this is amazing Overwatch.
Five.
Hope you guys are enjoying it. Two.
One.
Alright, I believe this may be the last round. Unless Red Team can capitalize on the final round situation. Mm-hmm. But, yeah. Oh, I love this.
Huge TP. Ball's just rotating. Oh, Shadow Dragon gets a pick! Super Wolf! The DPS getting some kills here. I'm pretty sure there's a cleanup and red definitely has this point. Let's go. I think this is the first map where we've seen Echo in play.
Blue team is going around back, and we'll see how Red Team reacts to that.
Former huge sim wall. Flame starts going to try and keep her team up.
Oh, nice. I mean, yeah, you always gotta enter here. Red Team is still holding down the fort. And they're getting these picks off of Flamestar and Destination. Silver Dipper.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Changing position.
I mean, Symmetra is just so good on this map, right?
Oh, yeah. And I mean, especially their comp really excels at just holding inside. And I mean, hey, Red Team's got 5 ults for this fight. I think it's looking pretty good for the Red Team, but we'll see.
Yeah,
Warmer finding another pick on Super Wolf, duping D.Va. Focusing Ally Rogue, and a huge shatter from Maxi! Huge plays, and only 2 ults used.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I wonder if they were gonna use all of the ults, but I guess that was just a great play.
Yeah.
3 left, and blue team just had 1 ult. This is not bad. Oh, there goes the
hammer. Yeah, I mean, they've got ults coming up, I think. I mean, Blue might be able to flip this, especially if they get some good mines on point. We'll see. It's
so good. Oh my god.
Does he kills two? Oh, and Blue just cleans up this fight. Amazing.
So was that Junkrat and Destination going off in the
yeah.
No, that was just Destination and the Hammy. Okay. I respect it.
Mm-hmm. That was a
like, big... what do you say? That was huge. Got coming in with a riptide here and kicked out four. Okay.
Well, blue team does not want to give up this point.
Yeah, and they're holding, and now they're climbing on that percentage there.
Touch from
I mean, that was really good. That was really good. What do you do here if you're a red team? Are you just waiting for your ult, or are you going to try to keep kicking?
If I was red team, I would try and go to the white room and not bridge, because they might get booped. Yup. Oh, oh! Madhawk stays on! Illy tried to boop him off.
Yeah, this is when you were calling
it.
This is so
close. Yeah. Oh, okay, big. Oh, it's still. Oh, no! Oh, no! Okay, but we get a dupe off? Oh, no. Tim finds Silver Dipper. I'm not sure how winnable this is. He was out of bag. Flimstar commits Co. Just make sure they hold this quickly. Yeah, I think they got it.
Well, red team is just at 70%, so I mean, blue team is at 70%, so they do get like one or two more big fishes, depending on how fast. If you can test a little bit. It's looking like one of the last fish.
Yeah, I think red team, they could win this here. They got a lot of really crucial ults. They have Shatter, they have Ko and Baptiste.
They may be able to call really so...
Yeah, we'll see. Oh, someone has a touch. Okay, big. Shatter. There's a tire though. It looks like red is up. Oh, no. Oh my.
It looks like it is. Wait, maybe not. Contesting.
Big TP by Reaper. It's not over yet. Another TP bringing in Symmetra and Baptiste. Flamestar will find Kiki. Ryan charges in. Yeah. Oh, I don't. Destiny kills two.
And the ham all just comes in.
Oh
my god. So it looks like blue team is gonna hold a lot of weight. They're gonna contest.
Oh,
I don't think they see. Is that
D-Bat
Mech?
Oh. Oh, and blue takes.
So close.
Victory.
Good job, blue team.
The Reaper teleported last second. Oh my goodness. Good job, Dusty.
That was a really, really good match. Yeah, Super Wolf really came in. I believe it was the all that came in. Oh no, it's all the double.
I mean, every single time Super Wolf tires, she finds like two kills.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, hey. If it's
crazy.
I mean, it has to be two or more, right?
Right?
Destiny, why don't you play like this with me? Silver Dipper, please. Oh my god. So that was tonight's games. That was really fun to watch and amazing. Congrats to the Corsair keyboard winner. And also, chat, I hope you guys had a great time watching some great Overwatch. Also, shout out to the doctor whose name just escaped me. I'm sorry, I'm a bad co-host. I have it here. Mm-hmm. Dr. Kate McGee, there we go. Shout out to Dr. Kate McGee, who gave us some amazing tips on fitness and gaming. She even gave it for like us regular folks, you know, not just the esports players like Knock here. But yeah, I just want to thank Knock for coming. I hope you had a good time. I hope next time you won't be nervous.
Yeah, I did. Thank you so much. It was fun. I loved watching. It was great.
Great. I got another co-caster I can call. but yeah, tell everybody where they can like find you. I don't know if you have social media or you know,
what
young kids call it. No, I'm kidding. No, go ahead. Tell them.
I'm Sometimes I stream. I don't stream that often, but my Twitch is nocturnal_gg. You know, you can watch me if you want. You don't have to. I just do it for fun. But yeah, thank you. It was a lot of fun. I loved casting. And you're a pleasure, Alley Cat.
Yeah, they kind of warned people about me before. They're like, she's like a burst of sunshine. It's because before I'm just like, I don't know. I need food and water. But when it's like time to, you know, go, we have to go. But yeah, thank you so much for joining me. You were such a pleasure. And I loved your insight, especially on like, you know, tanking and all that. And you called some really cool plays. And you called some really, yeah, you were really great.
Of course.
I hope I can have you again. Also, thank you to the Stevens College and Notre Dame High School team. Shout out to both coaches. Thank you so much. You guys are always welcome here, of course. Ormer, please don't get timed out. No 1v1. The stream is over. You're overtime. Char is tired. He's yawning right now, right, Char? Yeah. No, but thank you guys so much for joining us here on the Hive Weekly stream. This is episode 5, you know. Make sure you follow the Twitch channel. Follow Esports CCP on Twitter, as well as Instagram. Yes, there's an Instagram, there's Twitter, and there's a website, Esports CCP. So yeah, make sure you go check out all of that. Shout out to Bayou and Catherine, who's unfortunately not feeling too well, but let's wish her well. And also shout out to production, Char. I know y'all don't even know who I'm talking about, but he's really fantastic. Thank you so much to everybody who had a part in this. I hope you guys have a great Thanksgiving. Please be safe. Make sure you're super, super safe out here. You know, just do like a drive-by and pick up your food and call it. No, I'm kidding. But yeah, I hope you guys have a great Thanksgiving week. We will not be here next week, but we will be here the week after. So we just want to thank our sponsor, NFL Alumni, ESTV, and Corsair. And that's it. That's it. That's all we got.
So, bye.
Thank you, guys, and have a great night. And that's it. Bye.